Hi guys, and welcome to the channel. This is part two of our Silver Bayonet build that we're doing. Today's video is about the French Warband that we painted up. If you haven't seen part one, then at the end of the video, there'll be a link at the end of the video. Just click on that and that'll take you to part one. If not, what I'll do is I'll put the cards above here somewhere, or should be. Click on that and that'll take you there. Now watch part one and then you can come back into part two and sort of see the two different warbands, how they come together. So what is a silver bayonet? Again, like I said in the previous video, it's done by Joseph McCulloch, again famed for obviously many of the sort of skirmish rules and that now, and obviously an Oathmark as well. Frostgrave, Ghost Archipelago, Rangers of Shadow Deep, and obviously Frostgrave. So silver bayonet again is no different. It's a small little skirmish warband, round 8 figures you play with out on little missions and that to investigate certain things in the gothic horror sort of setting. So again, you can be meeting vampires, werewolves, that type of thing, you know, then goblins, hobgoblins, that type of thing. So in that sort of fantasy horror sort of setting and that. Really excited about this game and that, and say, and the British painted up now, the French is all done. We can certainly get some games and that on the table and I sort of start learning the rules. So without further ado, guys, I'll spin the camera around. Let's go and take a look at the French warband. So first up, for the French, we have the officer who's in charge of this little warband. Again, really nice. I love his coat and that he's wearing. It really does look like it's flowing across the body and across, you know, down and down and that. And it's really, really nice. Full of sort of character. That facial details on these miniatures are really nice and very sharp. And again, following like we did with the British, following the sort of colour palette that North Star used, we've done a similar sort of thing. Just follow the colour palette, just keeps it nice and simple and that. And you're not sort of messing around, looking through too many books and bits and pieces for colour sort of variations. And coming around now then, we have the Occultist. Now this one's really nice. Again, full of character and that. It's still, if you look, it's fantasy, but it's still got that sort of Napoleonic sort of theme and that in the dress and everything else, just with a few added extra bits and pieces and that onto it. And I think you need things like this. The Occultist and that is not in the British Warband, but it definitely does make this one a little bit different than that. It'll hopefully certainly play a little bit different with the attributes that each of those can have. So that's the Occultist and the Officer. Coming around now then, we have the Sapper. Now this one, look at this. This one is a really nice model. And I think there's an art print picture and that in the rule book of one of the sappers and that, and again I think they've captured it with this model very well. Really, really nice. Again, love his detail, the sharp lines and that you get obviously where the cross belts and that are on his uniform. Really, really nice. And again, it's sort of the facial details and that, and that is really good. Behind him coming around now is the Heavy Cavalryman. And again, this one is, when he comes around, you still see him and that, really does look like he's a sort of a heavy cuirassier sort of coming round. And it's pistol out, he's sort of having it, he's got his sword, heavy sword ready and that, ready to go into the sort of like deal with whatever's in front of him, not just like maybe the British, it might be something sort of from the gothic horror setting. But yeah, very nice, full of animation and that on these figures. Like I said before, I like all the miniatures and that, I've got full of character and animation. Coming up next then, we have the Vivandière. If that's how you pronounce it, great. If it's not, apologies. again, sort of the medic and that would be sort of out, sort of helping that. The French warband's been recruited in to help out the band. And she is really nice. Again, I love the way sort of her frock and that sort of like flows around and it's got the pleats and that down through it. Really, really nice and that. And again, certainly will add a lot of character and that into the game, and a different sort of flavour. And her rules are slightly different than the Doc. So again, I quite like that. Coming up now then, coming round, is the Grenadier. Now he does look like a grumpy old brute, doesn't he? Again, following sort of similar sort of like following the colour palette from obviously North Star, but obviously it is sort of representing that sort of like big long great coat and that they wear, that dark sort of blue. But again, you know, it could be grey, it could be anything you want, it'd be really browns or whatever, but you paint them up however you want to paint them up. Like I said, it's not meant to be rigid in the actual Napoleonic setting and that, you know, dot the I's, cross the T's, you know, the button counters, you can paint up what you like in that. It is, say, as a fantasy setting. And coming around now, we have the Veteran Hunter for the French. And I do like him with his mask over his front there. It's very sort of shifty and that. Yeah, very nice. Again, his coat really does flow over him, in holding out his pistol there. There's lots of other little, for the officer and that, in that you can equip them that as other sort of general armory, and there's some supernatural armory that you can equip them with, and different sort of bits and pieces. Most of the actual figures that you purchase for your warband and that comes set with what they are. Up next then we have, he has a supernatural investigator. And again, I think this one here, again, differently from the British one, I do like the way they all sort of look. Every sort of faction's got their own little take on them, a little bit of spice in that sort of adds the character and that and the flavour for what they are. But still keeping in that, you can sort of tell from a distance that's an investigator or that, you know, that's a veteran hunter. But yeah, very, very good in that. So really love these figures. And so I'll get the whole lot together and sort of see how we look. So there we have then, this is the French war band of eight figures all put together. And like likewise with the British, as I've said many times, they all do. If you said to me, what faction are they? You could tell they're French straight away. You know, obviously, you know, they look the part. They really are characterful for that Napoleonic setting, but also arching over into the sort of a fantasy sort of world and that. Really, really nice. And they say they're all just great figures, really. Don't matter what war band you play, you're going to have a lot of fun in that playing with them. So there we have it then, guys. That is the French Warband for the Silver Bayonet. And we hope you've enjoyed watching this video. And if you have, please hit the like, subscribe, notification buttons to be reminded from the next videos being uposted. And we are still in the process of doing the Spanish. We've nearly finished them off. And we're going to get that video out to you shortly. So that way you've got all three of the first wave of the warbands and that you've seen. And if you haven't managed to check out the British video yet, I'll leave a link there, as I said, at the end of the video. So you can click on that, go back and have a watch. Once again, thank you for watching. Hope all your projects are going well. And thank you to all the subscribers and that has joined on board this channel, our channel and that, and supported us over the time. And all the new subscribers that's jumped on board. And until next time, guys, please stay safe and happy wargaming.